हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर संदीप वाघ, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश, लोकनेत्य वेंकटराव हिरे कॉलेज, नासिक। दिस प्रेजेंटेशन इज़ फॉर पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ इंग्लिश एंड ऑफ कोर्स ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स एंड पीपल हु लव लिटरेचर। इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन आई एम क्रिटिकली एनालाइजिंग द प्ले महानिर्वाण, ट्रांसलेटेड एज द ग्रेट डिपार्चर by the famous Indian playwright Satish Alekar. Friends, Mahanirvan or The Dread Departure is the second play of Alekar, published and staged in 1974. The play was originally composed as one act play, but then it was extended to two acts. Satire, irony, black humor and absurdist elements are some of the notable features of Alekar's plays. The play reminds us as the absurdist plays like The Zoo Story and Waiting for the Godot. The play is a fine example of black humor or dark comedy. It is based on the incidents which follows the death of a person called Bhau Rao in the middle class chawl, the reaction of the wife and son and the neighbors of the dead man create humor and also brings out the hypocrisy in the Indian society. The dramatist laughs at the false seriousness which is obligatory during the death rituals. Here are some of the major characters in the play. The first one is Bhau Rao. Bhau Rao is the narrator in the play and he narrates the incidents that takes place after his death. The second character is Rama. She is a widow of Bhau Rao. The third major character is Nana. Nana is the only son of Bhau Rao and Rama. Then there are some minor characters like Chawl Men, Man on the Ladder, Man 1 and 2, Chowgule's family, Bandhu and his mother, Chintya, Priest Bode, Dattu, LIC agent, man with black goggle, watchman of graveyard, and other minor characters. Let us focus on some of the major characters in the play. The first one is Bhau Rao. Bhau Rao is the central figure or the central character in the play. The play is about his death, which is called as Mahanirvan in the play, the dread departure. He is the narrator in the play. He narrates all the events after his death related to his life. Secondly, he is a good husband. He loves his wife Rama and praises her beauty and kind nature. He is kind father. He loves Nana and praises him as a worthy boy. He calls him handsome and clever and fulfills all his demands. He is a pathetic figure also. Though we laugh on his humorous situation, we feel sorrowful about his condition. He has to wait for his own cremation and emancipation. In the entire play, his corpse was treated badly. Bhau is one of the symbolic figures. He represents all the middle class men who die earlier without fulfilling their own and family's desires. He represents the orthodox culture of the society. The second major character is Rama. She is the most beautiful and kind woman in the chawl. Bhau himself praises her beauty. Even Cholben peep into their house to see her. She is typical traditional Indian woman who used to wear sari. Like a true wife, she laments for 10 days after her husband's death. She is a good mother who loves Nana, and with the help of Nana, she performs all the post-death rituals of her husband. She trusts Nana and tells everything about the man in her dreams with black goggles. She is a symbolic character and she symbolizes hypocrisy. All her sobs and mourning were false. After the death of her husband Bhaurao, she wanted to live her life with the man of her dreams. Then the another major character is Nana. Nana can be called as the protagonist of the play. Though appears late in the play, he attracts our attention in the second half of the play. Like a hero, he has all the qualities of head and heart. He is the center of all the incidents. He proves to be a good man, good son. He consoles his mother after the death of his father. He struggles to do all the rituals according to the wishes of his father. He even tries to find out his mother's man of dreams. He is also a symbolic character. He stands for the modern young man from the middle class family. Like a modern man, he does not believe in superstitious post-death rituals. He stands for the progressive thoughts in the society. The play can be analyzed as a dark comedy or a dark humor. It can also be analyzed as an absolute drama or as a satirical play. Let us analyze it on these three levels mentioned before. The play can be considered as a conventional black comedy. The serious event of a death is presented in a comic manner. The death of Bhaurao is a serious event. However, the incident follows creates humor. For example, it is serious that Bhau is dead, but it is humorous that Rama thinks that he is sleeping late in the morning because he might have drunk heavily in the night earlier. It is serious that all are waiting for Nana for the funeral. However, it is humorous that one young man climbs the ladder and sees with telescope whether Nana has come. It is humorous that the dead man Bhaurao is the narrator of the story. He narrates it in the form of kirtan. That is, kirtan means singing of hymns. It is equally humorous that Bhaurao wishes to be burned at the old graveyard and not the new one. Adekar laughs at the hypocrisy of the characters and at the relatives for their false mourning. There are a number of incidents on which we laugh and criticize at the same time. Here, death is treated as a trivial thing. Hence, it can be considered as a dark comedy or dark humor. The play can be also analyzed as an absurd drama. It has all the features of absurd drama, like episodic or loose plot, theme of alienation, theme of lack of communication, nonsensical expressions, humor, wit and satire, sense of meaninglessness and nothingness, etc. All the features mentioned above can be found in the play. Hence, it can be seen as an absurd drama. The play can also be analyzed as a satirical play. It satirizes the hypocrisy of the characters, the behavior of the relatives and neighbors have been satirized by the author. First, the author satirizes the superstitious beliefs of an Orthodox Indian society. The sellers of firewood and kerosene, the watchman of the graveyard and the LSA agent represents the corruption and greed of the people in the society. Friends, it is also important to know the significance of the title Mahanirvan. The very title of the play Mahanirvan, translated as The Dread Departure, sounds parody. The word Mahanirvan literally stands for departing of great souls and sages. But in this play, it deals contrary with the death of a common middle class man, Bhavrao, who resides in a typical Maharashtrian chawl with his wife Rama and son Nana. The play is a tale, which in Marathi it is called as Akhyan, of the Mahanirvan of the father of the protagonist. The dead father, Bhavrao himself, tells the story of his death in the form of a kirtan. Friends, I have tried to analyze the play from different perspectives. Hope you would have liked this presentation. Very soon we will meet with the new topic. Till then, goodbye and thank you.